We have our models, we have our textures. Are you ready to make your product shine? In this tutorial, we're gonna be turning up the lights, literally. Whether you're showcasing sleek surfaces or subtle details, I'll walk you through how to light your 3D product scene like a pro. Let's bring your design to life, one dome light at a time. Hi creators, welcome or welcome back to Academic Phoenix Plus. My name is Monica and I am your guide through lighting and rendering. In this video tutorial, we're gonna go over how to light and render this product design. If you want to follow along, take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. There you can download this whole scene and follow along. If you're new to this channel, I post tutorials on a weekly basis. Software includes Maya, ZBrush, Substance Painter, and so much more. So if that is your sort of thing, please consider subscribing. So bring out that creativity, open up that software, and let's go ahead and get started in lighting this product design for a final render. Here is our beautiful work. We have our models, we have our UVs, we have our textures ready to go. Super excited about this. And as you can see right now, we just have a regular dome light. So let's make sure we're taking a look at the render camera. And you can see that, you know, it shows off our objects pretty well, but we can do a way better job. Can definitely make this pop. So I'm going to go to the two-point views, and on one side is going to be my perspective camera, and the other one is going to be my render camera, so I can go ahead and start lighting. Now, I want to have a little bit of a dramatic shadow, so I'm going to go ahead and create an edge loop and delete that back face so that it gives me this really nice looking shadow. So next, I'm going to make sure that I'm looking at the render camera. And you can see that nothing really major is going on, but there's a plan to my madness. I'm going to go ahead and select that dome. I'm going to start rotating it. Now I've hit play on my render window so you can see that it's live, which is really nice about Arnold. You can actually see live renders on the spot. All right, so I like the way it's starting to look. I want to use that hole that I made to make sure that I get some shadows and light. So it emphasizes my products at the front. If you're happy with that, you know, it's okay. But the problem with this type of lighting or the dome is that it's a very neutral gradient. It's a very smooth gradient and there are really not very many shadows. So I'm going to show you a wonderful website called Polyhaven. They are not sponsoring me. I just love them. And if you go to the assets and you go to the HDRI, you're going to find some free resources, which is incredible. And you can see that there's skies and indoors, studios, sunrises, nights. And I mean, you can just spend all day just working on just downloading these HDRIs. So I'm going to go through and just take a look at all of the HDRIs. And you can see that you have the actual HDRI at top. And then you have these little spheres that show you what it looks like in reflections, what it looks like in transparencies, the shadows, especially what it looks like on the floor. So it's up to you which one you want to use. As you can see, there's so many of them. I like to download 2K HDRI and then download them. You can do more if you like to, but those are pretty good. And eventually you're going to get yourself a whole folder, a whole library just dedicated to HDRIs. I like to put my HDRIs in source images because that's where Maya is going to look for any type of textures, including HDRIs. So let's go ahead and delete that dome. We're going to go to Arnold Lights and we are going to go to a sky dome. Click on the little checker under color. And then we're going to go to file and you're going to click on the little folder and let's go ahead and grab the dome. Now double check your color spaces raw. Let's go ahead and go back and render it out and see what it looks like. So you can see that it's already very, very bright. Again, we want to make sure we're looking at the render camera and there you go. Now don't forget, you can always rotate, right? So you can see if this is going to be a good place for it. Now, what's nice about HDRIs is that they provide reflections, and that's really important in these product shots because we're trying to make sure that we can choose a nice overall color and also what type of reflections are going to help highlight our scene. So you can see the difference of how the reflections and the highlights are affecting my product, especially in this transparent bottle. So again, it's about finding the right one for you. And don't forget that you can also mix in the regular sky dome. So for example, if you liked the original lighting and you wanted to get a little bit more of that blue color, you can. So you can mix domes. There is no rule that says you can't. So feel free to mix them up if you want to. I just wanted to have a little bit more color to it, a little bit more blue. Control H to hide it so you can see the difference. Go ahead and take a snapshot and let's go ahead and focus on other domes. I found another one that's a little warmer and I'm going to take this new dome and I am going to put it into source images. So again, grab that dome, go to the file, go to the folder and select that file. Let's see what it looks like. There it is. Now this one's significantly warmer. So the first one with the regular dome light, physical sky, it was very blue. The other one was very white, and this one is a little bit more brown. And I like the brown because it helps enhance the color of the fluid inside the bottle. So again, you can rotate it around and see if you can get a particular shadow. I'm trying to make sure that there's a shadow in the back and the lighting is in the front so that it looks really, you know, sophisticated. That's my goal here. And you can see that with this one, it does a really nice job highlighting the edges. You can still see the products really well. And then let's unhide the original dome to try to get a little bit more blue into it. Now I am going to increase the intensity of the HDRI dome because I really want to make sure that the products are visible, right? This is an ad. We need to make sure it's visible. So I'm going to reduce the intensity of the physical sky to about 0.4. It's just there as more of a background noise. So you can see how much of an impact it does. I really like the way the highlights are being affected by the bottle. It really enhances the shape. It also enhances the sides. And the nice thing about the physical sky is that you can go into the color balance and also make some adjustments. So if you want to, you can go in and kind of play around with these. And it will change the overall color of the object. You don't have to find a perfect dome. Sometimes you can find a dome and then maybe you want to change the color a little bit. You can also play with the exposure to increase or decrease the exposure as well instead of the intensity. There's just a lot of things Maya gives you control over, and it's pretty amazing. And I'm pretty happy with the way this is turning out. As you can see, if you wanted to make it cooler, if you wanted to make it warmer, if you wanted to do a variety of things. So you can see that that's looking, I'm actually pretty happy with that. Okay, don't forget to save. This is very important. And again, I highly recommend to always save iterations, version 1, version 2, version 3, just because they can easily be corrupted. All right, I really am liking the way these domes are. Again, it's up to you how many domes you want to try to experiment. There's just a lot of options out there. Now, I'm going to keep this lighting pretty simple. I'm not going to spend a lot of time, you know, adding spotlights and things like that, which in general I would recommend. But in this case, I'm just going to be focusing on lighting by a dome and also whatever the HDRI does. All right, next, if I'm happy with the way it looks, which I am, I'm gonna go into my render settings, go to my, all the way down into imagers and add a add imager, and we're gonna choose the lens effects. And what's fun about this is that you have the vignette, which will darken the corners, and it also will help brighten up the highlights. And this is a really nice effect because it will just push the render to the next level. So we always have these really nice looking renders, but we can add a little bit more by making the specularity look a little brighter and then have a little bit of that vignette. That's just a nice final render. So it's up to you how much of a glow you want. I do want it to be a little bit glamorous, but I don't want it to be overpowering that it looks like, you know, there's a fog or something going on. Let's go to the render settings. And one of the things we need to do is make sure that we increase. So if we're ready for a final render, it's time to increase our width and height so that we can get a final render. This has always been a preview. The width and height has always been a preview. This is going to be the final one. So I'm going to make it really large. The width and height is 1092 by 1236. And my resolution is going to remain at 72 DPI. But if you were going to do this for print, for example, I would increase that to 150, 300, and if you're going for like National Geographic, 600 DPI. But right now, for the sake of this tutorial specifically, I'm going to go ahead and just keep it at 72 resolution, which is basically for screens. Next is about increasing our sampling. So go to the Arnold tab and just kind of crank up everything by 1. I don't really have volume and I don't have subsurface, so I'm going to leave that. And then the adaptive sampling, let's go ahead and enable it and increase that as well. So that means that Arnold is going to spend more quality time on areas that are usually pretty noisy, which includes specularity, which includes shadows and the fall off of shadows. So we're going to go ahead and let this render. It's going to take a minute because I have increased everything. As you can see, the small one only took like a few seconds to render. But now that I've increased the settings and I've increased the quality and I've increased the aspect ratio and increased the Arnold settings, then it's going to take a significant amount of time. And that's always the debate about rendering and lighting is, do you want really nice high quality? Well, then it's going to take a lot of time. But do you have the time? And that's always the balance. The balance is how much time can you provide for rendering and how long it's going to take, right? So in this case, it didn't take too long. It was only about 2 minutes. But, you know, just think about it. If I was making a movie, then it would... you have to think about 2 minutes, 24 frames per second, 24 frames per second times two, you know, it's going to take an hour just to do a second. You know, those are the type of things you have to, well, not an hour, a little bit under an hour. But again, if you want high quality stuff, that's what you got to do. And that's why render farms were invented, right? So that you can render a bunch of stuff. And some render farms will actually just render certain squares in the or a grid pattern and only will render one aspect of it, of the image. It's amazing what people have come up with to render this fast. So there you go, everybody. It's a quick tutorial on how to light and render your scene. It's a lot of fun. You can see that you can produce some really beautiful images. Again, this product design is there to be flexible. You can change the lighting. You can change the tags. You can change the color really fast. And the client can just quickly say, instead of saying skincare, you can say something else. And we can quickly make those changes. So hopefully you learned a thing or two. If you did, please like and subscribe. That would be amazing. It helps me out. And it also helps me send the message out to other 3D artists and who need tutorials like this. Please share my videos. If you know of an artist out there that would like to learn how to light, please share my videos. That would be amazing. Don't forget to take a look at academicphoenixplus.com. There you can download this product design and also follow along. You can also take a look at all the other resources that I have, including ebooks and 3D models and more. And also take a look at my e-courses. I do have some e-courses for you. Again, thank you so much for watching. I truly appreciate it. Keep creating, and I will see you next time in the next video tutorial.